Hey guys, it's Ty from Table Flip Foundry. We all knew that one day I would be here checking out a brand new resin printer with you guys, and today is the day. I'm getting ready for my first look at the Elegoo Saturn 3 Ultra, and we're gonna check it out together. Let's go. The Table Flip Foundry print farm consists of a number of Elegoo Saturn 2 printers, and I'm excited to check out this new Saturn Ultra 3 to get the first-hand look at possible upgrades or replacements for the equipment. I know my printer room would look awesome with a bunch of these new sexy, sleek black printers all lined up in a row. Just as a disclaimer, this isn't going to be a full review, just a showcase of the new features and elements. I could do a deep review when I have had more time with the printer, but I'm about to open the box for the first time. Time to open this bad boy up. Looks like the first thing we've got, this is just a cord. Leveling card, so this is new. I will give this a try. I usually use paper, but this card should be the right kind of thickness that we're looking for, so we're gonna keep this handy. Lid comes off. All right, comes with a little tool kit. Let's set this aside for now. We'll look at it in a second. Looks like we've got our leveling screw. Get rid of that. Build plate. We're gonna keep this handy to put our build plate on, just to keep it safe for now. I can see that underneath the vat, there appears to be like a little peel tab, so let's take the vat off and peel that. The vat is just these two screws on the side here. All right, let's get this vat out. When we take this vat, there are screws on the bottom, so you can set it down flat on a surface, but we still wanna be very, very careful with the vat. Make sure you're setting it down on a clean area. So here we're gonna peel up the protective coating. Okay, so the screen, my understanding is the screen has a tempered glass protector on it built in. Now, if it's like the Saturn 2, I can tell you that I have had, so I've got, I think, 5 Saturn 2s right now. I've had plenty of my NFEP sheets rip or tear. I print pretty much 7 days a week, 24 hours a day. It's bound to happen, it's going to happen, it's part of the process. Just know it's going to happen. But the great thing is the screen protector on this is so durable, I've always been able to remove the resin. I take the plastic scraper, I cover it in some isopropyl, I take the plastic scraper and I just kind of go to town, and this tempered glass protector doesn't scratch. It always comes out. By the time I'm done cleaning, it basically looks perfect. So there is a screen protector on there. You don't need to go buy a second screen protector. Just use the one that's on there. If you do, you're gonna make it harder to print. So save yourself the effort, use the awesome screen protector that comes on these things. So this looks a lot like the Saturn 2. I think the build volume is almost the same, if not exactly the same. Now when you set this in, it should orient right there. You can feel it kind of click in, throw your screws in there. Have a look at this build plate. All right, so the build plate looks like it has this film on it. You can kind of see it there. Oh, that's so satisfying. So in this toolbox, the Saturn 3 Ultra comes with an air filter with a replaceable activated carbon cartridge. This printer has USB ports on the top of the printer for two of these carbon filters. It comes with one, but you can purchase a second one from the Elegoo website. The vat seems to be identical to the Saturn 2, and I like that they're interchangeable. Also, the vat holds just shy of a bottle of resin. The Z-axis has been upgraded a bit. It now has a ball screw instead of an old lead screw system. The ball screw is more robust and has higher precision. This model's still rocking dual linear rails just like the Saturn 2. The vat still uses the same threaded knob system that has been tried and true. I prefer the knobs with the threads instead of the threads built into the printer. I always worry about ruining the FEP accidentally by piercing it with the screw. It's a really small quality of life thing, but I appreciate that they still do it this way. As with most modern printers, this comes with a capacitive touchscreen. Elegoo has really stepped up their cosmetic UI game though. This new interface is looking really good. It's bright and it's clear to read. I absolutely love it. For those who don't like messing with USB drives and want to slice directly to their printer, Elegoo's included Wi-Fi on this one. Just be sure that your slicer is compatible with this system. A lot of people, myself included, have not been a fan of the ball joint leveling systems from previous Elegoo printers. Elegoo heard our cries, and now they have a fantastic 4-point leveling system.
system. Leveling was incredibly easy this time around for me. The Saturn III Ultra has a build volume of 218 by 122 by 260 millimeters, which is slightly taller than the Saturn III Standard and its predecessor, the Saturn II, but it has generally become an industry standard for mid-size printers. One of the most notable upgrades to the printer is the new 12K resolution screen. People say size isn't everything, but when it comes to LCD screens and pixel size, it's just not true. Smaller is better. The screen has a pixel size of 19 by 24 microns, which is incredibly small for a 10-inch printer. There seems to be some other technical details, like a new operating system and a brand new file type called .goo that is open source. The lighting system is very good, using a single large Cobb LED projected and reflected by a mirror into an LCD screen. This gives a more uniform and precise light path for the light rays. There are a lot of fine details to the quality of this particular printer. I think you should really take some time to read all of them over for yourself before making a decision on your purchase. I think you'll find a lot of the upgrades are worth it. So the question is the Saturn III Ultra worth the price compared to the Saturn II and the Saturn III Standard? And would I upgrade our print farm if I was given the chance? Well, I'm here to tell you, yup. Okay, I love you guys. Bye.